Okay, number five, enlist government's immediate to go along with the program to make, this is what the UN is doing. They're enlisting governments to go along with their program, basically.
And the media, that's why you won't hear about the truth.
You won't. Let me clarify the role of the media here. And I may make some media representatives here a little unhappy, but let me tell you what my experience is. One of them just piped up over here. People don't become journalists because they want to be great scientists. They go into journalism to change the world, to make it better. What a wonderful goal. That's admirable. Think of the great people that started off in journalism, that became great writers of great works. Ernest Hemingway. And if you get a chance, read the book, Endorsement by Carol Hemingway. But there's a role for journalism. It is not doing climate science. What they have to do is step back and make a qualified judgment over what is realistic and what is not. It's a very simple transition from going from global climate models that do not work at all to solar cycles that work over 90% of the time. You don't need to be a rocket scientist for that. You just need to be objective. I have found after 4 years that our media knows all about this. The media in general, I'm talking about the mainstream liberal progressive media represented by a few TV stations and a few major papers, but certainly not all, has decided to wink at the science and say, we would rather tell you that polar bears are threatened. We would rather tell you that the Antarctic is melting and we're going to have 20 feet of sea level rise, because we know even if we tell you something that's not true, we're going to get a great world as a result. And that's what's happening in the media. If there's anyone in the media that wants to talk to me, I'll give them all the facts. But after 4 years of talking to the media, that has been their response. When they do respond. And many of them don't want to talk to me. Many of the politicians don't want to talk to me. But that's the way it is. Many people who know about all of this, have known these facts for years, have consciously decided we're going to ignore that and we're going to play this game of doing something greater for the environment and climate because we think there's more important things we can get out of you. And in the last years, hasn't that happened? A group called Fox News has shown that you're absolutely right. Fox News, headed by Rupert Murdoch's corporation, and how much does our country owe to a guy who was not even born here? Rupert Murdoch. Don't we owe him a great deal? Let's hear it for Rupert Murdoch.
John, can you speak to the recent report of the Department of Education having a preschool day for children where they were teaching them about biodiversity and climate change? This is what's going on in the curriculums in our schools?
Very good point, Ken. The nature of how this is all being done is really insidious. I have taught in schools, and I have seen the very same thing. The curriculum that is in modern day textbook is all about climate change caused by man.
They don't do that anymore.
And this is going in the heads of our young people. It is disaster for the future. Because these young people grow up and they have it in here, deep in here, because they get it at an early age, and they start to act on that belief. False as it is, they will act on it. We now have the opportunity, because we have the knowledge and the data, to show all of this is wrong, to stand up and say before our education commissioners and education boards, and we can independently call Houghton Mifflin and anyone else who makes a book that has this stuff in it to stop telling lies. Start telling the truth. Start telling a balanced form. I would be happy if we got both sides of the story told, but we only get one side, the wrong side. There's a green technology transformation program that just came out from the UN. It is dangerous. It is literally deadly. And it is something you need to study. Go online, download it, read it.
Just, where would they find
just
that?
Just Google UN Green Technological Transformation, and you'll pull it up. This talks about sustainable development, but in very specific terms, it shows you how bad it's going to get. Look at these items here, E, F, G. CO2 emissions, again, it's the CO2 tool, the climate change tool that's being used. They're telling us that we're going to have to cut our emissions per capita by 77%. Europeans will have to cut energy, total energy consumption, by 50%. And every U.S. citizen cut their energy use by 75%. Ladies and gentlemen, this plan from the UN is nothing short of sending us back to the Stone Age within the next 30 or 40 years.
Yes, but John, we're too close to the speaker. But at the same time, the EPA is down here in Florida imposing numeric nutrient content requirements on our water and sewer treatment plants, on our farmers and things like that. We're actually they want us to filter the creeks and the rivers. That's all hugely energy intensive.
Yeah.
How are we supposed to cut down the when the government is saying use more energy?
Here's my answer to that. It came up recently in the Fish and Wildlife study that takes effect this year. And it is all based on, or a lot of it's based on man-made climate change. Somehow we've got to get our group together, this group and every group like it. We have got to file lawsuits to stop this punitive legislation. For example, anything, and I've said this before, anything that uses man-made climate change and man-made global warming must be stopped. It is a meaningless, worthless theory about a climate that no longer exists based on causes that were never proven. We've got to stop this lunacy. The only way we have left is to go to those town meetings, raise our opposition before anything gets passed, go to the state, go to attorneys that were willing to put in some time and labor, and file lawsuits to stop this bad science. I want you to join with me in doing that. I have offered my support to do that. We can all get this stuff stopped, but we must take action. That's the most important answer to that question. We individually can do something. We need to take action. I am not about to cut my energy consumption 75% to please the United Nations. Are you willing to do that? It's already begun in Europe, yes. And if you look at the carbon exchange, the carbon credit exchange, is still active in Europe. Fortunately, we got it killed here in the U.S. Yes, ma'am.
On the smart electrical new meters that they're putting out, they can control your electrical consumption. They can cut your unit off. They can cut your toaster off at any time.
Right. Smart meters are the key in the lock to your door, to your house. Once smart meters are installed, the government, including the federal government, if they want to cut energy usage, happens just like that.
That's being
smart meters are a real danger. We need to be very careful. Some places they're good to have. Others we need to be very careful of giving up our rights.
But those are being pushed as, hey, save money. Your budget is stressed. Cut your power usage by using a smart meter. It'll take care of the problem.
Right.
They don't tell you what the consequence is.
You can cut your energy usage significantly by using practical conservation steps. I do that at my house without having to go to a smart meter. I don't think the federal government needs to know what my energy usage is in my house. I would rather they put a smart meter on Al Gore's mansions around the world rather than do it at my house. Okay. I have so much to talk about. May I have five more minutes?
Sure.
Take what you want.
The smart meters, can we legally turn them down or have them removed?
It depends on under what guidelines they're authorized, because once they're authorized, you may have no control. So before the utility company comes to your house to put them in, you need to know your rights, and you need to stand up in front of the utility truck and say, listen, you're not legally authorized to do this. I haven't asked for it. Stop what you're doing.
We've got, as individuals,
we've got the right and opportunity. We need to exercise the right to protect our lives.